Hello people and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Deep Roy Choudhury and I'm just a normal guy who talks about stuff that seems interesting and important to me. And today I'm going to talk about the fact that, you know, a lot of people are basically feeling, the mental health of people is being affected by the lockdown because of the COVID-19 pandemic. And by the way, for the latest updates of the lockdown that I've got is basically that lockdowns have now been reimposed in many countries, in France, in Austria, I think, and also in Italy, and I think 70% of Portugal, I don't know how to pronounce it, but Portugal has now been gone into lockdown again. I think Spain is also under some kind of a lockdown again. I'm pretty sure that some kind of a rebound of that lockdown might happen again because of the upcoming winter. So the winter season could be much easier for survival. I am not an expert, maybe I am wrong, but I think the winter season is going to be kind of easier for the coronavirus, this novel strain of coronavirus, to survive compared to the scorching heat of the summer. Again, that's my guess, or that's what I think I read somewhere. I might be wrong about it. That's my estimation. Yeah, I might be wrong about it since I'm not an expert on this. Since I'm not a medical expert, I'm not an expert on this novel strain of coronavirus. I'm not a virologist. So the point that I'm trying to make is this. Either way, the lockdown that already has been there in various countries, in varying ways, in various forms, has detrimentally affected the minds of people. And even if, you know, there are countries that have avoided locking down their economy and instead enforced strict regulations like, you know, wear your masks whenever you are out outside your house, maintain social distancing, and don't be in packed crowds, and you know these basic norms that governments have encouraged. Some governments actually have had said that, you know what, we are going to avoid a lockdown altogether, and we are just going to instead urge the people to follow the rules properly. And so, you know, whatever it is, this scenario, this pandemic has created a sense of paranoia and a sense of fear amongst the minds of people. Even I, you know, when I'm going outside, I am just thinking twice about, I am paranoid about everything, about touching something somewhere accidentally. I'm always wearing gloves, which is pretty uncomfortable sometimes. I mean, really wearing the gloves after a point, it just, you know, the hands just get so uncomfortable. You just don't want to wear those gloves for a long amount of time because it is very, very uncomfortable. That is one. And number two is wearing the face mask all the time. I mean, it is covering your nose, covering your mouth, and after a point it really gets difficult to breathe, man. I mean, it does get difficult to breathe even in a surgical mask. I'm not saying I'm talking about an N95 mask, you know, I'm not talking about those special kinds of masks. I'm just talking about a normal face mask, whatever it might be, any kind of cloth, whatever it is. Even that might, after a point, gets uncomfortable, and people are just, you know. And so, you know, this lockdown, all these situations, all these norms are basically affecting the minds of people. And that has basically meant that there is a spike in the number of people asking for help from mental health professionals. So what is the solution? My solution would be to play video games if you can, to listen to good music if you can, try to maintain social interactions in the form of video calls, to your neighbors, to your friends, to your family, whoever it is that you want to communicate with. If you need to talk to someone, just ask for a therapist. There is no shame in talking to a therapist. You can chat anonymously with the therapist. That would be awesome. If you don't want to sit in front of a therapist, you know, one on one, then you can also chat on your smartphone. There are various apps, and so basically, you know, there are various things you can paint. There are a lot of people who can find out who try to discover their inner creativity through painting, who try to express their inner creativity through painting. There are people who resort to gardening. There are people who start reading books, novels, and all sorts of things. I should be reading, you know, I should restart reading books. I was reading books, but after a point, I just stopped it because I wasn't disciplined enough to complete books. So that is a letdown. The book that I was reading, the last book that I was reading, I think, was The Prince by Niccolo Machiavelli. I think it was The Prince. Am I saying the name of the book right? I have it on my, you know, Kindle. No, not Kindle, but Kindle app. Yeah, I don't actually have a Kindle. That device. I just have the, you know, Amazon Kindle app. So that's where I read my books all the time. I generally prefer e-books. But yeah, you know, the feel of a physical book is of course awesome. But you get the point. Read a book if you want to. Listen to good music if you want to. Play some video games if you want to. Go out for a walk. You know, now the lockdown is being lifted in some ways. So, you know, if you can make some time for yourself, go to a cafe with your friends or just by yourself as well. Go out for a walk in a park. That does help you become happy. You know, being in the midst of Mother Nature does increase your dopamine levels. I think, is that dopamine or oxytocin? What is that hormone? You just get happy in the midst of Mother Nature. You get the point. More on this in the next video, I think. Until then, please consider liking this video. Please consider sharing this video with your friends and acquaintances. And please consider subscribing to my channel. That would help me a lot. Until the next video, stay safe, goodbye, and God bless you.